Welcome to this Made for Success audio program. The audio you are listening to is designed to bring you hours of relaxing entertainment. Now sit back and relax as our featured story begins.
The following program was transcribed from its earlier network release.
The American Broadcasting Company and its affiliated stations present Mr. President, starring Edward Arnold. Mr. President, at home in the White House, the elected leader of our country, our fellow citizen and neighbor. These are little-known stories of the men who've lived in the White House, dramatic, exciting events in their lives that you and I so rarely hear. The true human stories of Mr. President. Let's visit Mr. President in the White House. It's evening. Only one window shows the light, a study on the ground floor. We find ourselves at the front door.
Come right in, please. The President's expecting you. Through that door, please.
I'll go right in. Some business for you, Mr. President.
Hello. Sit down, won't you? Why, of course it's all right. You know, before I moved in here, I had the idea that the president is somehow more than a human being. But believe me, he isn't. I get aches and pains just the way you do. All kinds of things happen at the White House here, and things people never hear about. Let me tell you a true story that's hardly known to all. Now, which president was it when it actually happened? I'll tell you later on. But meanwhile, see if you can guess. It started the evening I came back to the White House after taking a long, brisk walk.
Mr. President.
Hello, Captain Drew.
Are you all right, Mr. President?
Well, don't I look all right?
Yes, sir, only... where are McGrath and Cooper?
Ah, Captain, they're fine young fellows. They're the most pleasant bodyguards you ever assigned to me.
Pleasant be? They're not supposed to let you out of their sight.
I assure you, they didn't do it on purpose.
Oh, not again, Mr. President.
You'd have appreciated my strategy, Captain. I walked into the swamp, the one by the river. They did exactly what I expected. They ran around to the other side to pick me up again, but I turned right around and came out where I went in. You know, Hannibal did that once to the Romans. I hate being followed, Captain.
But we've got to guard you, sir. Yesterday, a bomb came in the mail. This morning, more of those threatening letters. Oh, McGrath and Cooper are going to catch it from me.
Don't be hard on them.
And I'm going to catch it from Miss Sarah.
Oh. Well, I won't tell her if you won't.
I can't fool Miss Sarah, sir. And neither can you.
You know, I was enjoying myself thoroughly until you said that, Captain.
I'm sorry, Mr. President.
Well, however, it was fun while it lasted. Can't you just see poor McGrath and Cooper running around and around that swamp? And waiting for me to come out? Good night, Captain.
Good night, Mr. President.
Oh, Captain.
Yes, sir?
You won't say anything to Miss Sarah?
I'll do my best.
Good night, Captain.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.